Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video, we created a series of questions for knowledge check. You have 10 seconds to answer each question. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Question 1. The correct answer is A. The SharePoint server farm is composed of three types of servers: web front-end servers, application servers, and database servers. And the type of farm, such as search, or services, etc. Question 2. The correct answer is A. Dash copy is available only on secondary copies with de-duplication and is enabled by default. Discrete optimization is the default method used, which optimizes data transfer by using existing data signatures. You can enable network optimized copy, which optimizes data transfer by performing data de-duplication on the source. Question 3. The correct answer is B. NSLOOKUP is a network administration command line tool for querying the DNS to obtain the mapping between domain name and IP address. Question 4. The correct answer is C. You need to install future release on comm server first, followed by media agents, and then client computers. Use the comm cell console update software feature to select the comm server computer along with media agents and clients during the feature release installation. The comm cell console installs the feature release on the comm server first, and then on the media agents and clients. Question 5. The correct answer is D. By default, one media agent is installed when you set up the comm cell. However, you can add multiple media agents to enhance the scalability of your setup. As we see, there is no defined limit at the moment. Question 6. The correct answer is D. When a file is read into memory, it is compressed into 128 KB blocks by default. A hash is generated on that compressed block, which is used for deduplication. But not all files are 128 KB in size, and not all files are evenly divided by 128 KB. If a compressed file is smaller than 128 KB, it will be hashed in its entirety, down to a minimum size of 4 KB. For larger files that have a trailing segment that is smaller than 128 KB, that segment will also be hashed in its entirety, down to 4 KB. Question 7. The correct answer is B and D. A role is a collection of permissions that defines the level of access granted to a user or a user group. Permissions allow users to perform tasks such as performing backup, restore, and administrative operations on entities. To use role-based security, you must create a security association between users, or user groups, a role, and entities. A domain controller is a server that manages network security and user credentials. Question 8. The correct answer is C. You can monitor the backups via command line and command center, but the console window that you use to monitor backups is the job controller. Question 9. The correct answer is B. De-duplication on the source side identifies and eliminates redundant data from the client. This reduces the data transfer rate over the network from the client to the media agent. Question 10. The correct answer is D. Virtual machines running on ESXi hosts can track disk sectors that have changed. This feature is called changed block tracking, CBT. On many file systems, CBT identifies the disk sectors altered between two change set IDs. On VMFS partitions, CBT can also identify all the disk sectors that are in use. If CBT is disabled or not functioning properly, an incremental backup might back up a complete virtual machine disk instead of only changed blocks, or revert to a full backup. Question 11. The correct answer is A. Data interface pairs, now called backup networks, are used to specify a source and destination network interface for two CommSale resources, such as a client and media agent, to communicate through. DIPs can be configured using host names or IP addresses. In this case, using an IP address will avoid DNS lookup issues. Question 12. The correct answer is C. MAPI is a client protocol that lets users access their mailbox by using Outlook or other MAPI email clients. By default, MAPI access to a user mailbox is enabled. Disabling MAPI access to a mailbox prevents the user from using Outlook to access their mailbox in exchange mode. Question 13. The correct answer is C. You can use the tape tool GUI to troubleshoot media in the library and run performance testing on the mounted media. The tape tool GUI is also available as a command line interface. Question 14. The correct answer is B and C. Block size is hardware dependent. All media agent operating systems, network devices, and tape libraries that will be backing up or restoring data must support the configured block size. Question 15. The correct answer is C. The virtual server agent manages backups and restores for virtual machines. The VSA is installed on computers that can perform backup and restore operations for a specific hypervisor platform. The virtual server agent can be installed on physical or virtual machines and can be used by itself to protect the entire virtual machine, or in conjunction with a guest agent to protect high transaction applications, such as the SQL Server agent or Exchange Database agent. We will end this video here. Let us know in comments how you did. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.